Dear class of 2020.
All I want is nothing more to hear you knocking at my door.
My name is Michaela Hishon. I am the Prime Minister of Banting's Student Council this year, and I'm writing to you today because since our first day of kindergarten, we're told that it will all be worth it one day. And turns out instead of a senior year, we got a whole bunch of online school. So for the next couple minutes, I'd like you to follow me as I turn back the clock to 4 years ago. Grade 9 taught me to always work towards your goals. As an eager freshman, I strapped on my green Crocs and I marched the hallways proudly from class to class. Even if I got lost, you would never be able to tell. I got up in front of my peers and ran for grade 9 representative on student council. And since I was the only one who had the courage to run, I won. I worked alongside my peers to plan events, and I always looked up to the one who made it all possible,
Jess.
She led the council with confidence, she was trustworthy, and always made me feel included and respected, even as the youngest member. And Jess, if you're watching this, just know how much your presence inspired me. All the way to this year, in my, sadly, short term as Prime Minister, I hope I had the chance to inspire future leaders just as you did. Grade 10 taught me that it's okay to grow out of things and move on. Even if something used to bring you joy in the past, it doesn't mean it always will or always should. After taking, competing, and teaching karate since the age of 5, it started holding less of a place in my heart until I finally decided to embrace the fact that I had moved on. I started learning new things like dance and lifeguarding, and I started forming friendships with those around me. Grade 11 taught me what true friendship means, and I'll let you in on my secret. That even when you're playing the butt of the horse in the school play, it doesn't matter because you're in there with your best friend. And this story is sadly true, however, I've embraced it. We were dance partners, scene partners, and best friends ever since. That spring, I also traveled the world. I seized an opportunity to meet new leaders from across Canada, and I met some life-changing friends that I will always hold dearly in my heart. I learned who I wanted to be as a friend, as a leader, and as a human. And finally, grade 12, senior year. The big one that's glorified in every single movie about high school ever made, taught me to never, ever take things for granted. Because I can't even begin to explain how much I regret every time I wish the school day would be over so I could go home. I miss every time I got stressed about missing the bus to work, every test I crammed for and didn't want to write. And the fact of the matter is, I would give anything to go back in time and relive these moments and even relearn these lessons. Because I miss every single 6 a.m. morning for band, every 11 p.m. event cleanup. I miss morning announcements and hearing "Good morning, Broncos," boom through the PA. I cringe when I think about every hour, minute, and second I spent staring at the clock in a class I didn't want to be in. I would redo every listening test in French class, every stressful presentation, rewrite every impossible exam. I would even get stuck in the hallway during O Canada, if that meant I could have just one more day. And that is how I know that my high school career was done properly. That after all these years, I didn't think I would have changed as much as I did. You know, they always tell you this will happen, but I never really believed it was true. When grown-ups say, appreciate the little things because one day you'll realize they were the best times of your life. And man, were they right. Because all we have are these pictures, these memories, and these people. So I hope that one day down the road, you're able to look back at this year and think, wow, what a time to be alive. The earth was dying, a pandemic shut down the country, one man's death sparked a civil rights movement unlike any other, and I got this website. Thanks for all your hard work. Here's a virtual yearbook to put an end to what has been a virtual year. Hope it makes up for it, they say. Well, I am saying no. I refuse to let these past few months influence the way I look at high school. We will get our graduation, and we will get to move on to bigger and better things. And we'll realize that it all happened for a reason. At least one can hope. Yours truly, Michaela.